Hello everybody, Ben Larry here. So I just want to show you the latest updates of what I'm doing with my mood app, okay? So the idea is I started tracking my mood and writing a score from 1 to 10 of how I felt about each thing in my life. And it started off just simple and eventually ended up with 20 or 30 different categories. Everything from what the weather is like, how much water I've drunk today, how much interaction I've had. And I think I'll go into it in more detail another time, but I just want to show you quickly what I've been working on. So what I did when I started, it was just a spreadsheet. I'd add a new column, I'd put the date at the top, and then I'd put my numbers from 1 to 10 all the way down. Simple as that. But in order to turn this into an app that other people can use, I need to start automating it and, you know, turn it into a program. So what I was doing today, I created this custom menu item which automatically adds a new column and automatically puts the date and time, if you can see that, at the top, 3rd of December, 12:01 PM. Because I figured your mood can change throughout the day, right? You might start off in a good mood or a bad mood, and in the afternoon something different has happened and you feel completely differently. And I wanted to have the possibility to add more than one log throughout the day, you know? So, like, you might do a morning, a midday, and an evening one, for example. I want it to automatically put the time. Because I think capturing the data is important, and then you can, like, analyse the data later on. You can see graphs of how you feel. You can see a graph of how much water you were drinking over the last 6 months and how it correlates to your mood, you know. So I think, what do you call it, like, sort of analysing the data can happen anytime in the future, but we're just logging it at the moment. Does that make sense? So in order to make that new column, I've been learning to computer program. So this is the code that adds the new column. I'll just talk you through it just so you can see what happens. This bit of code opens the spreadsheet. This bit of code gets the current sheet, because on a Google sheet, there's all these different tabs along the bottom. So that grabs the mood one. This one finds the last column that has data in it. This thing is what creates that custom menu. It's called Ben's menu. It adds an item called new column. That's what creates this little menu item here. And then it runs this little bit of script, which is where it gets today's current date and it gets today's time, and it formats it just as hours and minutes. And then it inserts a new column after the last column, and then it gets the first cell in that column and adds the date, and then it gets the second cell in that column and adds the time. And that can be activated, as you've seen from that menu. So when I click that, it'll run the function and it'll add the new column on the end, okay? So it's just, you know, this is just step by step automating the whole process. Now, I'm recording these videos, as you can see, and I'm creating a log for the videos as well. And I'm gonna automate some of this as well, but I haven't done that yet. So I'll tell you about that on the next video. Okay, thanks for watching.